be that small. God, I beseech thee, thy honor, state, and seat is due to me.
What? Threat you me with telling of the king? Tell him and spare not. Look, what I have said I will avouch in presence of the king. I dare adventure to be sent to the tower. 'Tis time to speak. My pains are quite forgot.
Oh, devil! I remember them too well. Thou slewest my husband Henry in the tower, and Edward, my poor son, at Tewkesbury.
Are you a queen, yea, or your husband king? I was a pack horse in his great affairs, a weeder out of his proud adversaries, a liberal rewarder of his friends. To royalize his blood, I spilt mine own.
Yea, and much better blood than his or thine.
In all which time you and your husband Grey were factious for the house of Lancaster, and Rivers, so were you. Was not your husband in Margaret's battle at St. Albans slain? Let me put in your minds, if you forget, what you have been ere now, and what you are, with all what I have been and what I am.
Murderous villain, and so still thou art.
Poor Clarence did forsake his father, Warwick, yea, and forswore himself, which Jesu pardon.
Which God revenge.
Fight on Edward's party for the crown, and for his meed, poor lord, he is mewed up. I would to God in my heart were flint like Edward's, or Edward's soft and pitiful like mine. I am too childish foolish for this world.
Hie thee to hell for shame, and leave this world, thou cacodemon. There thy kingdom is.
My lord of Gloucester, in those busy days which here you urge to prove us enemies, we followed then our lord, our lawful king. So should we you, if you should be our king.
If I should be, I had rather be a peddler. Far be it from my heart, the thought of it.
As little joy, my lord, as you suppose you should enjoy, were you this country's king, as little joy may you suppose in me that I enjoy being the queen thereof.
A little joy enjoys the queen thereof, for I am she, and altogether joyless. I can no longer hold me patient. Hear me. You wrangling pirates that fall out in sharing that which you have pilled from me. Which of you trembles not that looks on me? If not, that I being queen, you bow like subjects, yet that by you deposed, you quake like rebels. Oh, gentle villain, do not turn away.
Foul wrinkled witch, what makest thou in my sight?
Repetition of what thou hast marred, that will I make before I let thee go.
Wert thou not banished on pain of death?
I was, but I do find more pain in banishment than death can yield me here by my abode. A husband and a son, thou owest me, and thou a kingdom. All of you allegiance, the sorrow that I have by right is yours, and all the pleasures you usurp are mine.
Curse my noble father laid on thee when thou didst crown his warlike brows with paper and with thy scorns drewest rivers from his eyes, and then to dry them gavest the Duke a clout steeped in the faultless blood of pretty Rutland. His curses then from bitterness of soul denounced against thee are all fallen upon thee, and God, not we, hath plagued thy bloody deed.
Justice, God,
to right the innocent.
Oh, 'twas the foulest deed to slay that babe, and the most merciless that I ever was heard of.
Tyrants themselves wept when it was reported.
No man but prophesied revenge for it.
Northumberland then present wept to see it.
What were you all snarling all before I came, ready to catch each other by the throat and turn you all your hatred now on me? Did York's dread curse prevail so much with heaven? That Henry's death, my lovely Edward's death, their kingdom's loss, my woeful banishment could all but answer for that peevish brat. Can curses pierce the clouds and enter heaven? Why then, give way, dull clouds, to my quick curses. If not by war, by surfeit, die your king, as ours by murder to make him a king. Edward, thy son, which now is Prince of Wales, for Edward, my son, which was Prince of Wales, die in his youth by thy like untimely violence. I myself a queen. For me that was a queen, outlive thy glory like my wretched self. Long may thou live to wail thy children's loss and see another as I see thee now, decked in thy rights, as thou art stalled in mine. Long die thy happy days before thy death, and after many lengthened hours of grief, die neither mother, wife, nor England's queen. Rivers and Dorset, you were standers by, and so wast thou, Lord Hastings, when my son was stabbed with bloody daggers. God, I pray him that none of you may live your natural age, but by some unlooked accident cut off.
Have done thy charm, thou hateful withered hag.
And leave thee out? Stay, dog, for thou shalt hear me. If heaven have any grievous plague in store exceeding those that I can wish upon thee, let them keep it till thy sins be ripe, and then hurl down their indignation on thee, the troubler of the poor world's peace. The worm of conscience still deny thy soul. Thy friends suspect for traitors while thou livest, and take deep traitors for thy dearest friends. No sleep close up that deadly eye of thine, unless it be whilst some tormenting dream affrights thee with a hell of ugly devils. Thou elfish-marked, abortive-rooting hog, thou that wast sealed in thy nativity, the slave of nature and the son of hell, thou slanderer of thy mother's heavy womb, thou loathed issue of thy father's loins, thou rag of honor, thou detested...
Margaret!
Richard! Ha! Call thee not.
I cry thee mercy, then, for I had thought thou... that thou hadst called me all these bitter names.
Oh, I know I did. But look for no reply. Oh, let me make the period to my curse.
It's done by me and ends in Margaret.
Thus have you breathed your curse against yourself.
Poor painted queen, vain flourish of my fortune. Why strewst thou sugar on that bottled spider whose deadly web ensnareth thee about? Fool, fool, thou whetst a knife to kill thyself. The time will come when thou shalt wish for me to help thee curse that poisonous bunch-backed toad.
False boding woman, end thy frantic curse, and lest do thy harm, thou move our patience.
Foul shame upon you. You have all moved mine.
Were you well served, you would be taught your duty.
Serve me well, you all should do me duty. Teach me to be your queen, and you my subjects. Oh, serve me well, and teach yourselves that duty.
Dispute not with her, she's a lunatic.
Peace, Master Marquis. You are malapert. Your fire new stamp of honor is scarce current. Oh, that your young nobility could judge what 'twere to lose it and be miserable. They that stand high have many blasts to take them, and if they fall, they dash themselves to pieces.
Good counsel, Mary. Learn it, Marquess.
It touches you, my lord, as much as me.
Yea. And much more, but I was born so high. Our aerie buildeth in the cedar's top, and dallies with the wind, and scorns the sun.
Turns the sun to shade, alas, alas! Witness my son, now in the shade of death, whose bright outshining beams thy cloudy wrath hath in eternal darkness folded up. Your aerie buildeth in our aerie's nest. Oh, God, that seized it, do not suffer it. As it was won with blood lost, be it so.
Have done! For shame, if not for charity.
Urge neither charity nor shame to me. Uncharitably with me have you dealt, and shamefully by you my hopes are butchered. My charity is outrage. Life, my shame, and in that shame still live my sorrow's rage.
Have done.
Princely Buckingham, I'll kiss thy hand in sign of league and amity with thee. Now fare befall thee and thy noble house. Thy garments are not spotted with our blood, nor thou within the compass of my curse.
Nor no one here. For curses never pass the lips of those that breathe them in the air.
I'll not believe, but they ascend the sky, and there awake God's gentle sleeping peace. Buckingham, take heed of yonder dog. Look, when he fawns, he bites, and when he bites, his venom tooth will rankle to the death. Have not to do with him, beware of him. Sin, death, and hell have set their marks on him, and all their ministers attend on him.
What does she say, my lord of Buckingham?
Nothing that I respect, my gracious lord.
What? Dost thou scorn me for my gentle counsel? And sooth the devil that I warned thee from? But remember this another day, when he shall split thy very heart with sorrow and say poor Margaret was a prophetess. Let each of you the subject to his hate, and he to yours, all of you to God.